The Bible says in John 10:7-10, "So Jesus said to them again, Truly, truly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. If anyone enters through me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I come that they may have life and have it abundantly." In the book of John, chapter 10, verses 7 through 10, it says that none of the sheep hear another voice except the voice of the shepherd. You cannot know who the thief and the robber are without knowing Jesus Christ. In the scriptures, we see Jesus preparing a table of blessing before our enemies, which means there is no table without an enemy. King David says in Psalms 23:5, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies." And there is also no field without weeds, as it is mentioned in the book of Matthew 13:24-30. Jesus presented another parable to them, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while his men were sleeping, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went away. But when the wheat sprouted and bore grain, then the tares became evident also. The slaves of the landowner came and said to him, 'Sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? How then does it have tares?' And he said to them, 'An enemy has done this.' The slaves said to him, 'Do you want us then to go and gather them up?' But he said, 'No, for while you are gathering up the tares, you may uproot the wheat with them. Allow both to grow together until the harvest. And in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, First gather up the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them up, but gather the wheat into my barn.'" The weeds represent the persecution and all the crises in our life. They exist to promote God's purpose in your life. Weeds are the ground where faith flourishes. When have you ever said, "It is good for me that I have been afflicted," as David said in Psalm 119:71. "It is good for me that I was afflicted, that I may learn your statutes." The Word of God says that faith begins in a weak form. When we say in a weak form, it means to deny yourself, to pick up your cross and follow Him, to stop looking where you came from and look only where you are going. The Lord came to preach a new love, a new wisdom, and a new faith. This is the reason He found rivalry from His opponents. This new kind of love, wisdom, and faith cannot escape persecution. This is the true meaning of being born again. To be born again is to change from one form to another, from one purpose of life to another purpose of life, and from one way of life to another way of life. This means we have to change the purpose, way, and form of Jesus Christ. To be born again does not mean that you are perfect. When someone is born again, his strengths are above his weaknesses. For this reason, put your past aside. It is just a story, and instead pray because God is pleased to speak to every heart that lives in His will. A man cannot discover new oceans if he does not lose the sight of the shore. The shore is our old life, everything that has to do with our past. There is no discovery without grace, according to Ephesians 2:8. "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and not that of yourselves. It is the gift of God." And those who say they discovered the new life without grace lie. Jesus gives us discernment to know when it is the Spirit of God that speaks and when it is man that speaks, which is the flesh. To receive the spirit of discernment, you have to have a divine encounter with Jesus. Peter had one and only encounter with Jesus, and that was enough to give him the spirit of discernment. Peter had many people around him, but why was it that only he and not the others recognized who Jesus was? The reason is because he had entrusted his sensitive ear to the voice of the Savior. And Jesus said to him in Matthew 16:17, "Blessed are you, Simon, because flesh and blood did not reveal this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." To entrust yourself to the Savior, you need boldness, because boldness comes from an independent mind. To discover the new life in Christ, you have to change your old ways of thinking and make new decisions to embrace a new way of life, the new life in Christ. We have to live every day of our life as it is our last day upon the face of the earth. Because tomorrow is a mystery, yesterday is history, the present, however, is opportunity. We cannot control the circumstances around us, but we can control our behavior. When the truth, which is Christ, was ignored, he remained silent because silence cannot be misunderstood. When he did not see hunger and thirst for his word, he remained silent. The Bible says in Acts 8:26, "But an angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, saying, 'Get up and go south to the road that descends from Jerusalem to Gaza.'" We see Jesus' response to a man who was thirsty for the truth. A eunuch from Ethiopia was thirsty for the truth, and God sent him Philip. When you are thirsty for the word of God, God will find you. For this reason, you should not seek the blessing, but the one who brings the blessing. I encourage you to be sensitive to the voice of our shepherd, Jesus Christ, and not to be afraid of the weeds that you see around you. They are there for a purpose. Your faith needs these weeds to lead you to this new life in Christ, to discover him in a deeper way and to know him in such an intimate way that his voice is so clear to you that the thief cannot deceive or rob from you. Remain blessed, Apostle John Zavlaris.